Now we are going to start with Graham's law of diffusion or effusion. Now what is diffusion? It is the ability of a gas to disperse spontaneously and to form a homogeneous mixture. Effusion is a process in which a gas is allowed to escape under pressure through a fine hole from a closed container. Let's take up this law. This law was proposed by Thomas Graham. According to this law, at constant temperature and pressure, the rate of diffusion or effusion of a gas is inversely proportional to square root of its density or molecular weight and directly proportional to the pressure exerted by the gas. Mathematically, rate is directly proportional to pressure and inversely proportional to square root of density. If there are two gases, R1 over R2 will be equal to P1 over P2 square root of D2 over D1. If pressure is constant, then the formula will be reduced to R1 over R2 is equal to square root of D2 over D1, where R1 and R2 are rates of diffusion of two gases and D1 and D2 are their densities. As we know that molecular mass is twice of vapor density, therefore we can also write R1 over R2 is equal to square root of M2 over M1. Where M1 and M2 are molecular masses of two gases. Rate of diffusion is equal to ratio of volume of gas diffused per unit time. So volume divided by time. Volume of gas diffused divided by time taken for diffusion. Rate of diffusion can also be defined as distance covered by the gas per unit time. That is, distance traveled by the gas divided by time taken. It is also equal to number of moles of gases diffused divided by time taken. R1 over R2 is equal to P1 over P2 square root of D2 over D1 is equal to P1 over P2 into square root of M2 over M1 is equal to V1 over T1 divided by V2 over T2 or equal to D1 over T1 divided by D2 over T2, here capital D1 and capital D2 are distances moved by gases 1 and 2, which is equal to N1 over T1 divided by N2 over T2. N1 and N2 are number of moles of gases diffused and T1 and T2 are time in which gases are diffused. We can also write R1 over R2 is equal to D1 over D2, that rates are directly proportional to distance covered. Is equal to square root of M2 over M1. Next, we are taking applications of Graham's law of diffusion. It is used in detection of marsh gas in coal mines. Separation of isotopes. It is used for determination of density and molecular mass of gases. Next, we are going to take up kinetic theory of gases. It is applicable to ideal gases only. This theory was proposed by Bernoulli and next developed by Maxwell and Boltzmann. The postulates of kinetic theory of gases, all the gases are made up of molecules moving randomly in all the directions. The second point, the volume of the individual molecule is negligible as compared to total volume of the gas. Pressure exerted by the gas is due to collision of gas molecules over the walls of the container. Therefore, pressure is directly proportional to number of collisions per unit time, per unit area by the molecules on the walls of the container. All collisions between two molecules or between a molecule and a wall are perfectly elastic. Means that there is no net loss of energy, rather there is transfer of energy. And next point is gas molecules neither attract nor repel each other because they are far away from each other. And negligible force of attraction and negligible force of repulsion is present between them. Kinetic energy of gas molecules depend upon the absolute temperature. That is, kinetic energy is directly proportional to absolute temperature. The force of gravity has no effect on the speed of gas molecules. Calculation of kinetic energy. According to postulates of kinetic theory of gases, kinetic gas equation is given by PV is equal to 1 by 3 mnu square, where P is pressure of the gas, V is volume of the gas, N is number of molecules present in given amount of the gas, U is root mean square velocity, and M is mass of one molecule of the gas. We know that PV is equal to nRT. PV is equal to RT and n is equal to capital N means Avogadro's number 1 by 3 into m n u square is equal to RT. Here n is Avogadro's number. We can also write 2 by 3 into half m n u square is equal to RT, and half m n u square is equal to kinetic energy per mole. So 2 by 3 kinetic energy equal to RT, or kinetic energy is equal to 2 by 3 RT. This clearly shows that kinetic energy is directly proportional to absolute temperature, and this is equal to kinetic energy per mole or average kinetic energy per mole. Boltzmann constant K is equal to R over N. N is Avogadro's number, R is gas constant. Its value will come out to be 1.38 into 10 power minus 17 ergs per Kelvin per molecule. K is defined as gas constant per molecule of the gas. R was gas constant per mole of the gas. K, Boltzmann constant, is gas constant per molecule of the gas. So kinetic energy will become equal to 3 by 2 KT. KT, it means that kinetic energy per molecule or average kinetic energy per molecule. Velocity is related to the gaseous state. First one we are taking is root mean square velocity, or RMS. Square root of the mean of the squares of the velocities of all the molecules present in the given sample of the gas is called root mean square velocity. URMS is equal to square root of 3 PV by M. PV is equal to RT, so it will be square root of 3 RT by M. And mass per unit volume is density, so we can also write square root of 3P divided by density. Average velocity, it is arithmetic mean of the various velocities of the molecules. So average velocity is equal to square root of 8 RT by M pi. Average velocity is equal to 0.9213 into root mean square velocity. And root mean square velocity is equal to 1.085 or 1.086 into average velocity. The most probable velocity, the velocity possessed by maximum number of molecules of the gas at a given temperature, is called most probable velocity. So UMP, most probable, is equal to square root of 2RT by M. Most probable velocity is equal to 0.816 into RMS, root mean square velocity. Or root mean square velocity is equal to 1.224 times most probable velocity. So the ratio of most probable velocity and average speed is to root mean square velocity is equal to 1:1.128:1.224. This was asked in IIT JEE mains this year, 2013. Next we are taking mean free path. The distance traveled by gaseous molecules between the two successive collisions is known as mean free path, which is denoted by lambda. Lambda is equal to 1 over root 2 pi sigma square into RT divided by PV. Lambda is inversely proportional to pressure. As the size of gas molecule increases, mean free path decreases. At the room temperature and the pressure of 1 atmosphere, the order of mean free path is of 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter.